So normal matter makes up less than 5% of all the total matter and energy in the universe. So it's basically ignorable. The rest is made up of dark matter and dark energy. And dark matter takes up around 20 to 25%, with dark energy being 70, 75%. Already this presents a very interesting question, because why is dark matter about the same amount of energy density as dark energy? And yes, I know dark energy is like two or three times, there's two or three times more dark energy than there is dark matter, but in astronomy terms, that's not very much at all. This seems like a very strange coincidence. Like, just why are we in this epoch of the universe? Why did we find ourselves with basically no normal matters? We can forget about that. But then dark matter and dark energy are on roughly equal footings. This is a major question, because if dark energy really is constant in the universe, is if the density of dark energy remains constant with time, then as the universe gets bigger, there gets more and more dark energy. And no, this doesn't violate any laws of physics. It's just with a bigger universe, you can have more energy. So over time, the amount of dark energy is increasing. Over time, dark matter is getting more and more diluted. So why are we right now, when we're here and observing the universe, at that crossing point, at that tipping point? This seems like a very strange coincidence, and in astronomy, we don't like coincidences. We want explanations. We're wondering if this isn't just an accident, if there's really something behind it. We're wondering if there's a connection between dark matter and dark energy. Do they talk to each other? Are they related? Is there a new force of nature happening over there between dark matter and dark energy that doesn't touch normal matter? We call this kind of fifth force quintessence, for fifth essence or fifth force. It is a theoretical idea introduced to explain the potential relationship between dark matter and dark energy. It could be a coincidence, it could be just absolutely nothing and no big deal, and there's no deeper meaning, but it's there, so it's worth investigating. So it could be that there is an additional force of nature that connects dark matter together and connects it to dark energy, so that the amount of dark energy in the universe is somehow related through this new fifth force to the amount of dark matter. So it's no longer a coincidence. It's not an accident that they're roughly the same. There's a reason that they're the same, because they talk to each other. You can only have certain amount of dark matter before you have to build up dark energy, and vice versa. That's what this fifth force of nature would do. We wouldn't see it in any of our experiments previously, because we've been focusing on normal matter, which wouldn't talk. It wouldn't participate in this fifth force. It would be something that only happens in the dark matter and dark energy. To actually test this idea, we've had to run computer simulations where we make pretend universes, including the new physics that a fifth force would mean. Like, there'd be extra interaction between dark matter, that the amount of dark energy would change with time depending on the amount of dark matter. And when we run these simulations, we have good news and bad news. The good news is we're able to reproduce the universe that we see. There's, of course, these models are very hypothetical, very theoretical, so there's a lot of range of parameters, a lot of little knobs and levers to pull and twist. So when we do it just right, when we set up this fifth force in just the right way, we can reproduce the universe that we see, which is cool. It means this can exist in our universe and not violate things that we know, but it also makes it hard to test, because we're just reproducing the universe that we see, and the universe that we see is perfectly explained by no additional fifth force and it just being a coincidence between dark matter and dark energy. We've gone looking for evidence for a fifth force in the voids between galaxies. We've looked for it in the densest part of galaxy clusters to see if there's any little change in like the population of galaxies or the amount of gas or the temperature in clusters. So far, we've found no definitive evidence for a fifth force, and we haven't found anything that really breaks it or confirms it. So this fifth force in the dark sector of our universe for now remains purely hypothetical, a potential, a possibility, but has not been observationally confirmed. Is there a fifth force of nature? Maybe. So far, we don't think so, but you never know what tomorrow might bring. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Go to patreon.com/spamstutter, and I'll see you next week.